And I am back. This is Angel Shares Rugs Up. Yeah. This vlog provides you examples of primary sources. I mean, a lot of examples of primary sources. Here, you could also listen to a heartwarming example of a secondary source. The photos, artworks, sketches, song, among others, are actually obtained from the following personalities. And these are not just personalities, but actually academicians. With the like of Dr. Lars, Ubaldo, Dr. Victor Torres, Dr. Ailyn V. Kindipan, and Mr. Jose Costa Malabanan, also the page of FB page of Filipinas Nostalgia. Okay. Also in this video, it provides you a 10-item quiz just to assess your understanding about primary and secondary sources. So without further ado, let's enjoy, or shall I say, let's savor the photos, paintings, artworks, song, among others, included in this video. So, in the previous vlog, we distinguished the primary source to that of a secondary source. So, primary source is basically an eyewitness account or those objects that were produced in that event that we are studying. Then, secondary source, it's mainly interpretation based from the primary sources by someone who would like to assess, evaluate, and interpret those primary sources. So, examples, we have this one. Well, these are historical sources, of course, but mainly primary sources. Visual images as part of it. So, as you could see, we have four classifications of visual imagery. Primary sources, we have maps, we have photographs, sketches, drawings, paintings, and then cartoons. So, first, we have maps. So, it says something. Okay, just have to read it. Yeah, it reveals how space and geography are being used to emphasize trade routes, travel routes, structural build-up, etc. So, these are examples of maps. There. This is map of Manila. So, you can see the Pasig River and Sampaloc. Then, you have the intramuros. You have the current map as a primary source also. We also have the voyage of the Victoria, as you could see. So let's just take a look at the legend. Then we also have the spread of Islam in Southeast Asia. This is also a map wherein, there's also an interpretation of this because there's this coloring already and that color represents something. But the map per se, it's a primary source. Then another map. Okay, then we also have sketches and drawings that may indicate the conditions of life of the past society. So, let's take a look at the sketches and drawings. So, one of the sketches of drawings is this. This is actually in Intramuros, wherein you could see at the center, the church, that's the Manila Cathedral, the one that's on the right, that's the Palacio del Gobernador, and on the left, that's a building, the Ayuntamiento. It's like the city hall at the time because Ayuntamiento means city at the time. So it's like the city council or the city hall at that time. Currently, ganyan pa rin naman ang itsura. Pati yung nasa gitna ng tatlong buildings, yung pinaka statue. Meron pa rin statue doon. I think that's the statue of a pope, if I'm not mistaken. Pero yun, nasa gitna pa rin yung Manila Cathedral, yung church. And then, yung Palacio del Gobernador na ngayon ay Comelec. Tapos, yung nasa left na building, syempre, hindi na City Hall yan ng Manila kasi, syempre, iba na. I think that's the National Treasury Building, something like that. Okay? Not so sure about it, pero ganyan pa din. So, ganyan na sketch yung Manila Cathedral, Palacio del Gobernador, and the Ayuntamiento at that time. Then, you also have a sketch with regards to this one. This is actually, kung makikita nyo yung simbahan dun sa malayo, that's the City Hall. City Hall. isn't corrected. That's the church, the Antipolo Church, and you could also see here the mode of transportation aside from the houses, the many trees, and those people are actually walking. But mode of transportation aside from the kalesa that you could see along the street, eh, meron din na hammock. Parang hammock, dalawang tao na nagbubuhat sa isang tao na nasa hammock mismo. Yun, parang hammock. Then, we also have the sketch of the translation. And I also have this a sketch of Dr. Juan Luna Inovicio. Okay, Don, not Dr. Don Juan Luna Inovicio. Kapatid ni Antonio Luna, the general. No, pero mas matanda si Juan Luna. Kasi Juan, Antonio, two. Basically, mas nauna si Juan Luna kaysa sa Antonio Luna. Kay Antonio Luna. Bunso si Antonio Luna sa mga lalaki. Then we also have here a sketch. This is actually an ad. An ad, hindi ito ng damit o ng buhok na rebanded or what. Hindi naman siya rebanded. O hindi pa rebanded, usong rebanded nun. Actually, a sewing machine. Yan. It's an ad of a sewing machine. Then we also have cartoons for political expression or propaganda, also indicates the temper of the times. Cartoons, editorial cartooning, or political caricature like this one. We have this. Yan, si Uncle Sam na it symbolizes America. And looking at the map of the Philippines, so interested of the Philippines. So interested sa Pilipinas. So ito rin, yung maliit na nilalang dyan, nakikita nyo. It refers to the Filipinos or Philippines at the time. So ganyan ihalin tulad ang Pilipinas noon. Tapos yung tao na may malaki ang na may globo, di ba? And then there's this one authority na hawak-hawak yung Philippines daw. So I think that's US. Ano ba? Balik ka ba to Spain? Anong gagawin? Iano sa bangin? No? Anong gagawin? Okay, and the rest of the world, yung may globo na mukha, they await, or the world awaits what will happen to the Philippines. Ayan, parang ganun ang ibig sabihin. Ayan, so yung nasa bang tao, ganun ihalin tulad ng mga editorial cartoonist nung panahon ng mga Amerikano, ang mga Pilipinong considered to be bad Filipino. Yung mas nasa taas, mga good Filipino. Ayan. Then we have this one, another, says something. It might just be a sketch or drawing, but it says something, that's editorial cartoon. And we also have this one, the bigger in height, the more superior you are. And yeah, di mas Uncle Sam, ang laki-laki. Tapos may mga native, so ibig sabihin inferior, kasi mas maliit. Then we also have G.I. Joe, ang laki niya, tapos mga Filipino, ang liliit, so it says something again. Then, yeah, this one also, if you would like to talk about the story of Erap Estrada, well, you could also use this one as a primary source. Okay? Ito, kung isusulat mo 20 years after, no, ang buhay ni Duterte and Cayetano, you could use this. Especially nung panahon ito ng ano eh, pangampanya ng 2016. Yan, siguro pwede mong ano ibig sabihin yan. Okay, so this one could serve as a primary source. Okay, paintings and other artworks are visual representations based on the artist's expression or interpretation of events and ideas. These become useful historical sources when we have to know or understand the context of the period in which they are made. So aside from the context, you make sure that you also have to study or understand the context of the period that you would like to study. Okay, so a painting, yung nasa likuran ni Dr. Torres, that's Dr. Torres, nagpa-picture lang siya, but behind him, it's the Spolarium. So, hindi naman kami papakabog, meron din kaming picture. So, ganyan din, nilagay ko rin lang to para makita nyo gaano kalaki yung Spolarium na pinaint ni Antonio tuloy, ni Juan Luna. So, nanalo siya first prize nung time na yun. So, nandyan, makita nyo yung iba't ibang mga professors, teachers, nagtuturo ng readings in Philippine history coming from different schools, universities, from Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. That was in 2016. And with us, yung nakasuot sa first row na green, that's Dr. Rene Escalante, and who's also the current director of National Historical Commission of the Philippines. Ako yung nasa bandang likuran niya. Naka, ano ba yun? Blue or white yung suit. Then, you also have... Ito. It is actually a photo, pero yung itong taong nasa likuran na nagpipaint, that's Wanduna. At yung nakahigang babae, that's the prostitute na ginawang modelo ni Wanduna. Kinuha niya mga prostitutes, usually kinukuha niya to para mas murang bayad kaysa kumuha siya ng modelo na mahal. So actually, sa taas na may pinipinturahan na pinipaint ni Wanduna, ito yung ano, yung spolarium. Sa bandang taas. Bandang taas doon sa canvas na ginagamit ni Wanduna. Ayan. I don't know if you could see it, pero yung sa taas niyan, spolarium yun. Tapos yung may frame na kung saan doon nagpipaint, yun si Wanduna. Then we also have a sketch of Wanduna also, the Philippine flag. You could see it at National Museum. Then aside from sketches and drawings, we also have photographs. So let's just see kung ano yung mga photographs as primary sources. We have this one. Si Jose Rizal. As we all know, this was a gift from a European country to us. And this one, mga Katipuneros. Okay. So it is said that pictures tell 1,000 words. Today, however, with the advent of technology, pictures can easily be made to lie. But you have to be vigilant, ha? If we would be using pictures or even videos. But photographs still tell stories, and from it we can distinguish details that tell the other side of a story or something beyond text. It is also a record of the past that is useful for historians. Okay? Okay, we have here, I obtained it from Filipinas Nostalgia. So this is how Estero de Benando, early 1900s. Oh, yan ang itsura nun. And again, from Filipinas Nostalgia, the Bridge of Spain or Puente de España. Before Jones Bridge, ito po yung pinaka-bridge dun sa yung kinokonekta niya ang Binondo at saka yung sa bandang Loton. Okay. But this one was actually destroyed because of the flood in 1914. Kaya napalitan ng Jones Bridge. Okay. This was also taken from Filipinas Nostalgia. Ano to? Sa may Intramuros. Yung nakikita niyong building dun sa behind the wall, that's actually San Juan de Dios. Na ngayon po ay that's Lyceum of the Philippines University. So, Puerta del Parian, that's actually the gate or entrance na ang pangalan nung entrance na yun, it's Parian. So, ngayon naman ay na-reconstruct, na-revive. Kaya meron pala. Pagpunta kayo sa Intramuros, you could see there the Puerta del Parian or Parian. Okay, so we have here also a picture of typical school children circa 1900. Okay. Naman, bakit silang lahat nakasimangot? Kasi nung time na, hindi naman katulad ngayon na isang click mo lang, okay na. Noon, matagal. Kaya kung una nakasmile ka, sa sobrang tagal, baka mapapa, ano ka na, diba? Kasimangot ka na lang. So just take a look at the faces of the children, especially the second in front, from the right, diba? Okay, kung ngayon ay may baha, dati din ay may baha. So this was the Great Flood of 1914, which destroyed the bridge that I mentioned a while back, na yung pinalit ay Jones Bridge. So yan, may baha din noon. Kung ang tough, ngayon binabaha, dun din ay binabaha din. Objects and artifacts, example, we have this, the Manunggul Jar, na it serves as parang burial jar. Yan. Ilalagay nila dyan. Then we also have the ceramics. You can see at National Museum. We have porcelain that was unearthed, or shall I say, nakita nila, or they found it in Laguna. We also have the burial jars. Aside from the manunggal jar, meron ding burial jars na nakuha nila sa may itom saranggani at ino naman ang itsura. Then we also have the lithics or that they found in Palawan. Ito yung mga tools no ng mga sinaunang mga ninuno natin na natumira dito sa Philippines. So lithics derived from lithos, lithos means stool. So ito yung ginamit nila as stone tools. Okay. Lithics derived from lithos which means stone. Yan. So ayan ang ginagamit nila parang tools. Aside from that, found in in Palawan, they also found tools from Cagayan. These are lithics also. Then we also have the golden tara. Okay, yan ang itsura. So this only means na meron talagang trading relations ang Philippines at saka India. Kasi nakuha nila ang golden tara sa bandang Mindanao. Okay, then we also have the balangay or boat. Ayan. Na nakuha nila sa Butuan. So marami actually nahukay nila sa Butuan. Kaya if you go to Butuan, there's a museum there where you could get to see yung mga nahukay nila na balangay. Then we also have the Doctrina Christiana, the first printed book in the Philippines. Then aside from the artifacts, yung mga remains na ginawa ng mga tao noong unang panahon as sources, as primary sources. Then we also have considered to be fossils, no? Mga bones. And the first, we know, siguro elementary kayo, high school, we know that the Tabon man, these were the first people who inhabited the Philippines. But actually, it's not a man, it's a woman. This was quote-unquote discovered in Lipuan Point, Quezon, sa Palawan. Pero ngayon, hindi na po ito yung pinakamatanda because in 2007, nahukay nila ito. No? At ito ay mas matanda daw sa Tabon woman. Yan, nahukay. Yan. Yan. At tinawag nung 2007, before 2019, na Kalyaw man because it was found out. It was unearthed in Tabon, Kalyaw Cave, kaya tinawag na Kalyaw Man. Yung Tabon Man, o Tabon Woman, kaya tinawag na Tabon Man because it was quote-unquote discovered in Tabon Cave. Ito naman, Kalyaw Man. But it was in 2019 when this Kalyaw Man was actually renamed to Homo Luzonensis. So, mas matanda po ito kaysa sa Tabon Woman or Tabon Man. Okay? So we also have this one that was excavated in Calatagan, Batangas. Then let's just take a look at the Philippine social life. So these are the pictures, 19th century photographs sa market to. Ayan, class picture ata to. Nasa gilid si teacher, yung mga nasa matanda, nasa klase niya, may matangka, may maliit. Pero nasa gilid yung teacher. Siguro ngayon, usually yung teacher nasa gitna. Okay, we also have this, a favorite pastime ng mga Amerikano yun, mga sayawan yan. Yan, marami yan nun. Pauso din sila aside from the golf courses. In 1970s, panahon ni Marcos, meron silang ganito. Bandang taas, tignan natin. Yan, actually yan yung ano, yan yung itsura, air pollution index. Ano ba yan? So, nakuha ulit sa Filipinas Nostalgia. Yun, April, sa likuran niya daw, meron April 1978, Philippines checks the atmosphere. So, tinitignan kung ilang pollution ba, kumbaga. Yan. Air pollution control panel na makikita sa Quiapo Square, Manila. Records the degree of air pollution. Taray, di ba? That was in 1978. Panahon ni Marcos yan. Then, events also. So, we have this, the execution of Rizal. We have also, I think these are the Katipuneros. Were the Katipuneros. This is actually in Baraswain Church. World War II. and also a newspaper wherein it carries the news that the Philippine Airlines bumagsak carrying the Boy Scout. Personalities, we have these two surviving pictures of Andres Bonifacio. Yan, dalawang legit yan. Tapos tignan natin yung bandang right kung ma-enhance pa natin o matitignan natin. Ayan yung itsura ni Andres Bonifacio. And we also have Jose Rizal. Then we also have, who is this? This is Antonio Luna, the general. Was actually assassinated by fellow Filipino soldiers also. Who is this? Paciano Rizal, the brother of Jose Rizal. This is Manuel Manuel El Quezon. This is stolen shot of Emilio Jacinto nung siya ay kakadakip pa lang sa palanan Isabela. So pabalik na siya, ibinabalik na siya sa or papunta na siya sa Manila. That's Emilio Aguinaldo. That's also Emilio Aguinaldo sa left, bata. Matanda na si Emilio Jacinto. Yan. Kasi 90 plus siya namatay. I think 94, 95, something like that. Eto, mga mugshots din. Yeah, mugshots of male and female inmates coming from Filipinas Nostalgia. This is also considered to be a primary sources. So, yan. Ganun, hindi orange nun ang damit nila. So, ganyan yung black and white, I think. So, may mga babae. Yan. Pictures. Tapos, yung kaso nila, murder. Yan. Yan, may mga babae. Siyempre, may mga lalaki din. Yan, mga itsura ng mga Filipino nung dati, mga 90s, 1990s. Eh, 1990s. 1900s, 1910, mga ganyan. Then, may mga foreigners din na gumagawa ng karumal-dumal. Kasi meron pa dito, triple murder eh. Okay. Then, also historic structures like this one. This is Quiapo Church, may itsura nun, early 1900s. This is Taal Church in Taal, Batangas. This is post office, panahon ng mga Americans. I think this was 1920s. This is the building of De La Salle before the war. This is This is Intramuros before the war. This is UST. Na nasa loob ng Intramuros nun. Okay? Ang UST nasa loob ng Intramuros nun before na nilipat nila sa Batang Espanya. Then, again, we have this entrance, yung parian. Then, you also have Luneta, and ang itsura ng Luneta ng early 1900s. Then, we also have Paseo de Magallanes in Intramuros. Yung paseo yung nakita nyo sa ano, parang nakatayo na nasa harapan ng building na parang number 8. Yan yung Paseo de Magallanes in Intramuros. So, ganito yung tsura niya. Ganyan. But this one was actually destroyed in World War II. Ayan. Yan, yan na. Kaya ngayon, hindi na natin makikita yan sa loob ng Intramuros. Then, as other kinds of primary sources, we have chronicles, and then friar accounts. Yan yung mga examples niyan. Then, we have memoirs done by P. Jacinto, and then also personal accounts by Aguinaldo. Then, we also have newspaper and magazines. Yan. So, syempre, kailanganin lang naman natin yung newspaper magazines. Kung, let's just say, our topic would be the story of the past, like an event na nung panahon, sabihin natin, ng 1930s, nung 1935. So, yung mga newspaper at the time and even magazines, we could consider it as primary sources for us to interpret what had happened in 1930s in the Philippines. Pero kung newspapers ngayon, magazines ngayon, they're telling us stories about what had happened in 1930s. Those are considered to be secondary sources. So, depende on how you treat it or on how you use it. Then, other example of primary sources or kinds of primary sources, we have legislative journals, court records. We also have speeches, and one of which is the SONA or the State of the Nation address by the President here in the Philippines, and even personal letters. We also have online database bases just like JSTOR and blogs. Okay. So, blogs, depende kung tungkol sa buhay mo yung kasaysayan. Yung blog mo, pwedeng gamitin nila o gamitin ng ibang tao para gamitin as a primary source. Pero kung blog ko tapos it says something about, let's just say, 18th century life of the Philippines, then that blog is not considered to be primary source. This is a secondary source because I'm just interpreting the life during the 18th century here in the Philippines. Then we also have recorded interviews as a primary source. Okay, so ngayon naman ay secondary source. As we all know, secondary source is just interpretation based from the primary sources. So example of this, we have textbooks, Philippine history textbooks, mga scholarly journals, ganun din ang biography. Pero I'll also give you an example of a secondary source. This is a song that is dedicated to Macario Sakay. Who is Macario Sakay? Malalaman nyo kung sino siya sa kantang ito. Okay, music please.
Macario Sakay, na bayani ng dukat aliping, kayumangging lahi, ang awit kong ito'y dalit at papuri sa'yo at sa ibang may dakilang ligid. Ikaw ay tinawag na isang tulisan, gayong ang hangad mo'y paglaya ng bayan, tulad ng supremong Andres Bonifacio, hamak at mababa ang tingin sa'yo, bayaning lumaban sa Kastila at Kano, sa gisag ng kasalukuyan tayo'y mga hangal, kolonyal na isip ang siyang sumasakal. Si William Howard Taft ay may Taft Avenue, may Murphy, may Lawton, parangal sa kano. Isang kaunlan, isang balik tunay, nasa ng kalim parangal kay Sakay. Patayin ng gobyernong kano na mapangalipin, siyam na put, siyam na taon na ang nakaraan, waring na waglit na sa aming isipan. Huwag kalimutan ang laban ni Sakay sa bansa. Ihando kanyang digmaan upang palayain itong ating bayan.
It's Macario Sakay, tutuloy ang laban ni Sakay. Okay, that's Macario Sakay, Pangulo ng Katagalugan. No, it was composed and sung by Mr. Joel Costa Malabanan. The song is considered to be secondary source. And then the video that you've watched or that was just presented, it was actually directed or created by Miss or Dr. Ailyn V. Kindipan. So most of the pictures or photos that were actually used, and even some of the quotes are considered primary sources. Okay, kahit secondary source itong video na to, pero 'di ba sabi nga natin sa previous vlog natin, yung secondary sources meron din naglalaman ng primary sources. Okay po. And then, yeah, as I promised, aside from those example of primary and secondary sources, meron tayong 10 item quiz just to assess our understanding about primary and secondary source. So I just hope that you have your paper with you, pencil or pen, para tignan natin kung ilan ang makukuha natin just to assess our understanding. Okay, just write primary source or P or secondary source or S. So I'll give you 5 minutes in every item. So let's start. Wala mo ng music. Okay, number one item, you have 5 seconds. Alright, second item, this is a radio broadcast from the day the Bataan fell from the Japanese forces. Alright, item number three, the Philippine constitutions, primary or secondary? Number four, a role play showing how Macario Sakay was executed. Item number five, a story describing Andres Bonifacio and Daniel Tirono's confrontation in the Tejeros Convention written by Agunzillo. Item number six, a contemporary artist's painting of what life was probably like in the 19th century. Item number seven, the History Channel, explaining the traces of Austronesians in Asia and beyond. Wala dapat apostrophe sa channel. Number eight, a movie showing the life of Gregorio Goyo del Pilar. Number nine, an interview with a soldier about what it was like to be assigned in Sulu, primary or secondary? Finally, number 10, a legal document signed by two contracting parties. Okay, you have 10 seconds to finalize your answers from 1 to 10. And after 10 seconds, I'll have to reveal the key to correction or the answers. You just have to check that ilan yung nakukuha nyo. So, dapat, syempre, 10 is the highest. So, sana maka-7. 7 yung passing rate natin or passing point natin, ha? Okay. So, let's see. Okay. Key to correction or the answers. Now, paki-check na lang. Ilan ang nakuha? Kung 10, excellent. Naintindihan mo talaga ang primary sa secondary source. Pag 9, very good. Pag 8, good. Pag 7, fair. 6, needs improvement. 6 to 1. So, ulitin na lang yung video. Lalo na yung previous video or vlog. Okay? Finally, bonus natin, repositories of primary sources. Pag sinabi natin repositories, these are areas, places, or buildings we're in. Dito po tinatago yung different primary sources or mayaman ito sa mga primary sources. Like the following. Paki-check na lang. Yan. National Archives of the Philippines, National Library, yan. Mga yan, magkakalapit lang yan sa bandang Kalaw. Yan. Meron din to. The four big universities, mayaman din sila sa mga primary sources. Kailangan nyo lang ng referral letter from your university or school to their university, dun sa library nila. Then we also have this, Library of Congress and National Archives and Records Administration na nasa US. Marami yan tungkol sa bansa rin natin because they colonize us, of course. And even in Spain, sa Archivo General de Indias and Archivo General de la Nacion. Marami rin mga primary sources. At malamang meron din pa rin mga nakatagong pwedeng mga primary sources na hindi pa natin nakikita. Meron din sa American Historical Collection, Lopez Memorial Museum, and Ayala Museum. So, kung gusto natin mag-aralan ng isang significant event nang nangyari, of course, nung nakaraan, so, puntahan nyo yan, mga yan, para makita kayo ng iba't ibang mga primary sources dyan sa mga repositories na yan. And, cut! So, again, ayan, para mabilis lang tayo, tapos na ang ating video. This is Angel Shares Ragsak saying, as always, it is cool to be learned. Ciao! Love you all. And stay safe.